an infamous axe murder, haunted battlefields, sea vessels overrun by ghosts. Massachusetts is home to a plethora of paranormal phenomena. Next up is one 200 square mile area that has been the site for a slew of unexplained occurrences. Here's the Bridgewater Triangle. What's the story?
Recently, UFOs have teleported from the pages of sci-fi novels into mainstream news headlines. The issue is getting a serious look on Capitol Hill after the public release of footage taken by Navy personnel that shows objects in flight that defy explanation or identification. The videos were confirmed as authentic by the Pentagon, and in July of 2023, Congress held oversight hearings and established the Unidentified Aerial Phenomena Task Force to study what they call UAPs. Even though UFOs are only now getting some legitimate attention and a rebrand by our government, Massachusetts has amassed a long history of sightings. The hotspot for so many of these intergalactic visits is an area known as the Bridgewater Triangle. Its points are in the towns of Abington, Rehoboth, and Freetown, with Taunton, Raynham, Berkeley, Dighton, Brockton, Easton, and Bridgewater inside the triangle. Cryptozoologist Lauren Coleman was the first to identify the area in his 1983 book, Mysterious America. Looking at the overwhelming number of esoteric phenomena reported over hundreds of years, Coleman saw a definitive, quote, window of unexplained occurrences in the 200 square mile area. Perhaps inspired by the Bermuda Triangle, a popular vortex of mysterious happenings at the time he wrote his book, he gave Massachusetts its own paranormal triangle. Anecdotes of Native American ghosts, cryptic animals, cult murderers, unexplained rock etchings, giant snakes, and ancient birds are all part of the Bridgewater Triangle lore. Included in this lore are hundreds of UFO sightings, including one of the earliest documented sightings in America. Let's beam ourselves back. On a May morning in 1760, witnesses in Bridgewater described a, quote, sphere of fire, brighter than the sun, emitting light intense enough to cast a shadow in midday sunlight. They described the sound it made as, quote, being heard sooner at the middle of the course it took than at the beginning. Historical records show that a similar light was reported that day in Roxbury. In another early account dated Halloween night in 1908, two undertakers, ooh, creepy, were driving a carriage in the wee hours of the morning from Bridgewater. They described a light that seemed like an unusually strong lantern moving in the sky. It was about 2.5 feet in diameter and illuminated a large object that looked like a balloon bag. The men noted in their account that a hot air balloon would not be able to maneuver in the perpendicular and circular ways the object moved. They also said it seemed to move up and down at the, quote, will of an individual. One of the most famous Bridgewater Triangle UFO sightings happened in 1979 when two well-known news reporters from WHDH Radio, Steve Sabrakia and Jerry Lopez, were on their way to the dog track. Around the junction of routes 24 and 106, they pulled over when they saw what looked like a bright light hovering over the tree line. As it passed over their heads, they described what they saw as something, quote, shaped like home plate on a baseball diamond, with a bright red light on its top, a powerful white headlight at the point of the bottom, and rows of white and red lights around the edges. Finally, and most recently, hosts of the History Channel show Beyond Skinwalker Ranch may have experienced some UFO activity while they were looking for another Bridgewater Triangle legend, the elusive Pakwudgie. A mysterious magnetic disturbance interfered with their technology and kept alerting them to fly their heat-seeking drone, quote, with caution. On the ground, they had three compasses, each showing a different north, and their thermal imaging technologies picked up what they described as a notable heat signature from a subterranean burrow. This all culminated in witnessing many luminous orbs going across the sky. UFOs or not, they definitely tapped into some good old Bridgewater Triangle fun. And friends, pondering aliens is where we'll leave you. What do you think? Are we being visited by beings from other galaxies? Thank you for spending time with the local scene. If you haven't already, follow our channel and keep updated on what's good and good to know.
Hey friend, thanks for stopping by. If you like this video by the local scene, share the love and give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe.